Fly, and welcome to It's All About You,
where we're going to be playing you 50 feel-good festive tunes
and sharing some of our best Christmas memories.
And doing it all in some very cosy knitwear.
Mine's a beach, actually. I might have to turn mine off.
That'd be really good. I'd like to see that.
Only joking. Talking of dodgy clothing, let's kick things off with Daryl Hall doing his best Simon Cowell impression at 50 with Jingle Bell Rock.
Mine's not dodgy.
Very dodgy.
It's nice.
It's all about you.
It's all about
you. Merry Christmas! We're McFly, and your timing is impeccable.
Yes, it is, because we've a whole clutch of Christmas crackers left to unleash, starting with this one.
Hello, we're McFly, and you've stepped inside our musical Winter Wonderland,
where, aside from bringing you 50 of our most loved Christmas classics, we're going to be sharing some of our fondest festive memories, too.
Yes, don't be fooled, guys. This isn't just a treat stood behind us.
Is it not?
No. It's a Christmas tree of truth, the tree of truth, littered with probing Yuletide questions. So who's going first?
Probe Harry first.
Yeah.
Here we go. It's right there, behind me.
What's the best Christmas present you remember getting as a child?
I remember getting like the Matrix on VHS. That was a really good Matrix.
Yeah. I got that as well.
Did you? It's really cool. And I was ill that Christmas, and I just stayed in bed and watched Neo.
My aunt got me Pandemonium on the PlayStation. Bad.
Mine was a tractor.
Really?
Yeah. You got a tractor?
Well, a little plastic.
You got a tractor? How old were you?
Not a real one.
Like a John Deere.
Christmas is always better when you're a kid.
It's true.
Unless you're Calvin from S Club Juniors, who had a massive unrequited crush on Rachel Stevens.
We've all had one of those, though, right?
Absolutely, I still do, in fact.
Yeah. Don't worry, Calvin. Time heals everything.
Doesn't, Calvin.
Well, most things.
It doesn't.
Probably won't heal what you've
Depends
got.
Depends what it is.
Hey, guys. Time for another break, but join us for more Christmas crackers and McFly anecdotes on the other side.
It'd be Rudolph not to.
A good one. Good one.
Huh? Meant to laugh at me, lads. Christmas.
It's all about
it's
you.
About you.
It's all about.
Hello.
Hello. We're McFly, and if it's amazing Christmas anthems you're after, then it's no trouble as far as we're concerned.
See what you did there, mate.
Good, no?
It's catching on, isn't it? My humour.
Let's play the next video, shall we?
Time for a quick break from our Christmas countdown, but there'll be more artists slaying it on the other side.
And hopefully less terrible festive puns.
No, we can't make any promises.
Still to come, we'll be sharing more festive McFly memories and play some of the greatest Christmas songs ever.
And I tell you, you do not want to mistletoe it.
Really?
What?
Mistle.
What?
Welcome back!
We're McFly, and right now, we're all about Yule.
Very good, Danny. Which means we'll be hanging out in our Winter Wonderland.
Answering more festive questions.
And bringing you a whole load of Christmas chart classics.
Sound good? Then keep watching.
Did you just blink?
Yeah. We're taking a break now,
but join us on the other side when we'll be delving even deeper into our sack of Christmas classics.
See you soon. Welcome back to McFly's All About Yule Countdown,
where aside from our top Christmas tunes, we'll also be sharing some of our favourite festive memories with you.
First, though, another seasonal classic.
At 30 on our Christmas countdown now is a boy band we used to watch whilst growing up, E17. Mm. What do you think of the Walthamstow boys, Harry?
Big fan, big fan. I particularly like Barry.
That one.
Yeah, these guys were actually really famous for their tall beanies and a dog called Levi in an epic Christmas number one in 2004, which turned out to be their only, and I repeat, their only chart topper.
Wow, but what a chart topper it was. Here's E17 with
Stay Another Day.
Stay now.
Baby, you got to go away. Don't think I can take the pain. Won't you stay another day?
Stay now.
Stay now.
Stay now. Stay now. Steve yet?
If not, stay put as we return with more Christmas anthems and questions from our Tree of Truth after this.
It's all about you. It's all about...
Merry Christmas! We're McFly, and your timing is impeccable.
Yes, it is, because we've a whole clutch of Christmas crackers left to unleash, starting with this one.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hi. We're McFly, and this is our All About Yule Top 50.
Which means us in snazzy knitwear, you in dazzling winter wonderland, and legendary Christmas songmakers giving you warm, fuzzy feelings down below.
Ooh, steady on, Tom. First, though, time for some festive questions. And, Danny, your turn.
It's my turn?
Yeah, yes, mate. Sure, mate.
Oh, okay, well, I'm going to go, like, down here. I get this one.
Perfect.
Oh, great.
All right, you ready? Whoa, 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 whoa.
Didn't see it.
Look at the tree of truth.
I didn't see it.
You'll be.
I didn't see it.
False. Who do you want to kiss under the mistletoe this year?
Natalie Portman.
Natalie Portman.
So I claimed it.
Portman.
Claimed it.
Already thought it in my head, so done. Shotgun. Wow. Natalie Portman.
Oh.
Turn around, touch the ground. Natalie Portman. Shotgun. Natalie Portman.
If she's watching this, she's definitely not going to kiss.
Someone else is getting a bit steamy under the mistletoe now. It's our shaggy-haired beefcake at 25.
Mm. That's no way to talk about Cindy Crawford, Harry. Honestly.
Hey guys, time for another break, but join us for more Christmas crackers and McFly anecdotes on the other side.
It'd be Rudolph not to.
A good one.
Good one.
Huh? I meant to laugh at me, lads. Christmas.
It's all about it's you. About you. It's all about...
Hello. Hello. We're McFly, and if it's Amazing Christmas anthems you're after, then it's Snow Trouble. As far as we're concerned.
Yeah, see what you did there, mate.
Good, mate.
Catching on, innit? My humour.
Let's play the next video, shall we?
Time for a quick break from our Christmas countdown, but there'll be more artists slaying it on the other side.
And hopefully less terrible festive puns.
No, we can't make any promises.
Merry Christmas!
We're McFly, and you have stepped inside our snowy winter wonderland.
From here, we're going to be playing you 20 of the finest festive songs in existence.
Sharing our own seasonal secrets.
And doing for Christmas jumpers what Ollie Mers did for sales of stupidly tight trousers. Looking sharp, lads.
First, though, it's time for big hair, big beards, and one of the biggest Yuletide singles of all time. Apart from the ones we've covered, obviously.
Here's Wizard with I Wish It Could Be Christmas Every Day.
It is, Dougie, that's right.
Yes.
Still to come, we'll be sharing more festive McFly memories and play some of the greatest Christmas songs ever.
And I tell you, you do not want to mistletoe it.
Really?
What?
Mistle...
What?
We're at number 17 now, and it's an X Factor winner's single that bagged Christmas number one in 2008.
But before we can reveal who sang it, I reckon there's just enough time for another question from our Christmas Tree of Truth.
Oh, yeah, I want to get it. I want this one here.
Go get it.
Oh, this one's been calling my name.
Tom.
Back on your spot.
Question, mate.
Where will you be spending Christmas this year?
I'll be with my mama and papa.
Really?
Yes.
Nice.
And my brother and sister.
Nice.
And my wife.
Nice. That's who, but the other question was where.
True,
so
true.
I'm afraid that's incorrect, Harry. No points. Dougie.
I don't know yet. I like to play Christmas chicken and just decide on Christmas Eve.
Great. Danny?
I'll be at home with my two dogs, nice. My mum and my nan and my sister and fiance.
Nice. I will be
up the
home
road.
As well, up the road. We'll come over.
Yeah, you're cooking as well.
I'll bring
so
a bit of turkey down for you.
That'd be awesome. Well, back in 2008, X Factor winner Alexandra Burke spent her Christmas releasing the biggest selling single of that year.
And lining hundreds of candles into a perfectly straight line.
Wow. Which is an important skill. Here's...
Hallelujah! Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
tune. That was him.
Leave it to Burke.
Boik.
Welcome back to McFly's All About Yule Countdown.
Where aside from our top Christmas tunes, we'll also be sharing some of our favourite festive memories with you.
First, though, another seasonal classic.
Feeling festive yet? If not, stay put as we return with more Christmas anthems and questions from our Tree of Truth after this.
Hi, guys.
We've reached our All About Christmas top 10 now, and I'd say it's about time for another question. Who's game? Yeah?
Yes.
Sweet. Do you know?
I think I'm going to go for this one, guys.
Good choice.
Good choice, I reckon.
This one?
Yeah, that one. Awesome.
Sparkly blue.
Okay.
Let's have a look, shall we?
Describe your Christmas dream.
Ooh, I would say it would just be me and you guys, actually. Just,
Gotta be a fire there.
Fireplace.
So it's a dream Christmas. You can have dragons and elves.
A festive dragon? Natalie Portman dressed as an elf.
Oh,
dragon.
Yes.
Serving us tea and fruitcake.
Yeah. Nice. Whilst riding a dragon.
Mm. Yes. There you go.
Talking of dream Christmases, one boy band secured theirs back in 1999 with an ABBA cover that clinched the Yuletide number one.
It is, of course, Westlife with I Have a Dream.
Surprised I got through that.
We're at number 8 now, which means it's high time for another probing bauble from our Christmas Tree of Truth.
Of course it is. Harry, you've been a good boy this year. Pick yourself something nice.
I have, haven't I?
You have, mate, yeah.
I think I'll just make it easy and go for this one. Looks good. Nice blue. What have we got here? What's your favourite Christmas memory?
Christmas memory.
I like the first year we all lived in the band house together, and we went and got all those Christmas lights and we decorated our band house all nice and festive. Mm. And then we never took them down for the next 5 years.
They just stayed there.
It was Christmas every day in the band house.
Talking of Christmas memories, here's one from 1987.
A year when the late Mel Smith and Kim Wilde recorded Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree to raise cash for Comic Relief.
A great cover and a top guy. Enjoy.
Hey guys, time for another break, but join us for more Christmas crackers and McFly anecdotes on the other side.
It'd be Rudolph not to.
A good one. Good one.
Huh? Meant to laugh at me, lads. Christmas. It's
all about... Hello. Hello! We're McFly, and if it's amazing Christmas anthems you're after, then it's snow trouble as far as we're concerned.
See what you did there, mate.
Good, no?
Catching on, innit? My humour.
Let's play the next video, shall we?
We are McFly, and you are watching our All About Yule extravaganza, and Danny.
No, you don't say.
Do you mind? We're supposed to be doing a show here, Jones.
You don't
Danny.
Say.
Danny.
Oh, sorry, mate.
What was that?
I don't know, I didn't say. Sorry, I'm just trying to organise a bit of a get-together, you know. In my mind, nothing says Christmas like an old sing-along down the old pub.
Yeah, if you're Paul McCartney and living in 1979.
What do you mean by that?
That's what's about to happen in our next video.
What?
Wonderful Christmas Time by Paul McCartney.
No.
Never mind, here's number 5.
So I spotted it earlier and I thought it looked like a good one.
That's quick.
Okay, here we go. Have you been an angel this year, or will you be on Santa's naughty list?
Oh, I don't know.
Good question.
Naughty boy. You've been a naughty boy.
I have, but I've served my punishment now, and I think I'll be on his good list.
Very I think
list.
We've all been good boys this year.
Apart from you.
Right, forget us, because we've got the voice of an angel lined up for you now.
Yep, that's true, Danny. This song was written way back in 1944. After hundreds of covers by some of the biggest names in music, Christina Aguilera's version remains one of our all-time favourites.
Ah, here she is with the Christmas song. All about you,
it's all about... Up next, a true Christmas anthem by one of the greatest musicians ever to grace the planet.
Vanilla Ice, right, yeah?
Nope.
O-Town.
No.
Chico from Rose Factor.
No, just no. It's written by John Lennon and Yoko Ono in 1971. And this Vietnam War protest song is as much a part of Christmas now as tinsel, reindeers, and fighting over the last stuffing ball. We covered it once, didn't we, boys?
Yes, we did, Tom. We did cover it. It was good.
It was really good.
It was good. Yes.
So here it is at number 3. Happy Christmas, open brackets, war is over, close brackets.
Happy Christmas, Julie.
So this is Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Wait a minute, Fly, it's time for the last question of the show. But before we reveal our number one, Dougie, you're up.
Great choice. I was going to go for that.
What do you want for Christmas this year?
I want a gap.
A gap year.
Just give me a gap.
I'd like a leap year.
A leap year.
I don't really want anything for Christmas this year.
No?
No.
Not even your two front teeth?
What's wrong with these ones?
Because the song's famous. So.
Say, I'm all right. Don't bother getting me presents.
Well, now you know what we want for Christmas.
It's time to check with Mariah Carey instead.
And there's no doubt what she'd like to find in her stocking.
Me?
Nah.
No.
So, it's nearly time to reveal our number one Christmas classic. Mm.
But before the festive fun takes over, how about a recap of our top 10 so far, would you reckon? Good?
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
At 10, Westlife had a Christmas dream.
I'll cross the stream. I have a dream.
At 9, the Pogues and Kirsten McCall were living in their fairy tale of New York.
And the bells were ringing out for Christmas Day.
While at 8, it was Mel and Kim rocking around the Christmas tree.
At 7, Wham had girl problems in Last Christmas.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. But the very next day, you give it away.
Destiny's Child were at 6 with 8 Days of Christmas.
Doesn't it feel like Christmas? It feels lovely.
Doesn't it feel like Christmas?
Feels so lovely.
Feels like Christmas.
And at 5, Paul McCartney was having a wonderful Christmas time.
Was Christina Aguilera and the Christmas song.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
At 3, John Lennon and Yoko Ono wished us a happy Christmas.
And a so happy Christmas. Back and forth.
While at 2, Mariah Carey only had eyes for you.
That means there's just one track left to inject you with all the important Christmas spirit.
And it's a pretty special one for us.
I think we've covered this before, actually.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, I seem to remember we've done this in the past.
Well, at number one, here's Michael Bublé with Santa Claus Is Coming to Town.
Enjoy.
So Michael Bublé is our number one Christmas crooner with Santa Claus Is Coming to Town.
We hope you've enjoyed our musical Winter Wonderland.
And we wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
With God.